This simulation looks at a gate that is only partially submerged in water. So the water height you can see indicated by the green. There's a weight due to the fact that the gate has a weight, and that's the blue line pointing down indicating the weight, and we can change the weight of the gate. And then there's, of course, the force on the gate because of the water, and this is located perpendicular to the gate in two-thirds of the distance from the top of the water level. A cable is represented by the green line, and the idea, as the water height decreases, then of course there's less tension on this cable. Likewise, as the weight of the gate decreases, there's less tension on the cable. And then we can change the angle. So this angle with the horizontal decreases. Notice that now there's more tension on the cable. As the angle decreases, we have a bigger moment arm due to the weight of the gate. And we also have more area in which water is applying pressure to the gate. So notice as the gate goes down, the force due to the water increases. And at some point, as I lower the weight of the gate, the tension becomes too high for the preset value for the cable to break, and the cable breaks. Then this simulation allows you to see the various distances and how they're changing as we change the angle, as well as showing the forces change. And we can also look at this in U.S. units of feet and pounds force, as opposed to more standard SI units, force in kilonewtons and distance in meters.